My name is Katherine Methling, and I attend the Cathedral campus. I grew up in a Christian household. My family went to church every week. We went to Christian schools. When I went to college, my relationship with the Lord really started to fall apart. There was boys and parties and drinking and friends and all of those things that were right at my fingertips. I pretty much stopped going to church. Quite honestly, I was probably too hungover on Sunday morning to make it there anyways. And I fell into a pretty sinful and foolish lifestyle for several years and made some pretty terrible choices that I had to then deal with. I specifically remember I stole my older sister's ID to go out drinking one night. And my dad, he looked at me and he said, "Katherine, I don't know who you are anymore. I barely recognize you." And I just brushed it off my shoulder. You know, I said, "I'm fine, I got this. I've got everything under control." I wanted to handle it alone. In 2016, I moved to Chicago post-grad and was still kind of living in that party lifestyle for a while. But I ended up moving one block north of the Cathedral campus downtown. And I met my husband, Max, about 6 months later, and we started going to the Cathedral together. I remember those first couple times coming to the service, I was just brought to tears nearly every single time because I was faced with the reality of how far I had wandered in my faith. And I knew that there was only one way to fix that, and that was by following Jesus and asking him to come in and help me. You know, it wasn't one hard moment that I had that realization, but it was over time and gradual that God worked in my heart. And since then, God has been doing just amazing things in my life. My priorities have completely flipped upside down. Max and I joined a couple small group at Harvest about 2.5 years ago. And that not only has been a wonderful way to study God's word among fellow believers, but also to surround ourselves with a group of people that show us every single day examples of God's goodness and faithfulness. October of last year, I got baptized at the Cathedral. It wasn't as scary as I thought it was gonna be. Something that happened after my baptism that I wasn't fully prepared for. Spiritual warfare has been a really big part of my life in the last several months. Satan does not like obedience to God, and so when we step out and make an act of faith and get baptized in front of your church, there's bound to be attempts to try to pull me away from God and doing these things. My life has been just filled with trials, just trial after trial after trial. It seems like every week there's something new that comes up out of the blue that I wasn't expecting. But the difference now is that I'm not alone. I'm not alone like I thought I was 10 years ago. I have God to help me through all of those trials. And despite Satan's attempts to try to pull me away, my trust and reliance on God has only grown stronger. The one thing that I see God really doing is just grace at every step of the way, woven completely into my life. And I don't deserve it. I've done nothing to deserve his grace. But I know one thing's for certain is I don't intend on wasting it. He uses those trials in your life to help bring you closer to him. I made choices that took me down to the bottom of the ocean, and God didn't let me drown. You know, he's the ultimate lifeguard. He pulled me up, he saved me, and breathed new life into me. That's how great he is.